Hello, Aquarius. How are you today? Welcome to my channel, Irish Donna Tarot. My name is Donna Wilder-Hart. We are here to do a love reading for Aquarius for the new year. We're going to take a look in detail with the 10-card Celtic. We're going to get started momentarily. For all of those visitors who may be new to tarot, this is like a buffet table. Not every portion of the reading is necessarily meant for everyone. It's a general reading, so take what resonates, leave the rest behind. I want to give a big shout out to my subscribers for your beautiful support. I am so touched. My heart is so touched and grateful for all the support you've given me, especially in the last couple of weeks. So let's get started with your reading. Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus of Aquarius. I highly suggest that you look at all of your signs for messages. It will give you a very full and rich picture of what is going on. We're going to do a 10-card Celtic, and of course I will clarify. So if you do like the reading, please like, subscribe, share, and comment so that YouTube gets the message that the content is worthy, okay, of your viewership. Thank you. Okay, so we have the Two of Wands. Aquarius, you are at a crossroads. There is a fork in the road, and it is time to make a decision. All right, so we have you rushing towards something, following your heart, listening to your heart, intuitively going after a goal. King of Wands energy, very passionate Leo energy. So we have Cancer, Aries, and Leo here. So gorgeous. King of Wands energy, the Leo energy is your seventh house of marriage and long-term commitment. Nice. Okay, Aquarius, in the past, you have left something behind. You have walked away from something to have your fulfillment. We have the High Priestess energy. You followed your intuition to, you know, move forward into a happy place. Gorgeous. The Eight of Pentacles, you are studying something. You are studying, you are figuring out what you want in the future. You're learning more about somebody or something. Look at this, Four of Wands energy. For many of you, you are dating somebody that looks like they could be the one. The Sun card, Leo energy again. Your seventh house is activated. Leo energy, and we have the King of Wands here. The Four of Wands is a marriage card. As you can see, we have a bride and groom that is all about stability, happiness, commitment, buying a home together, building a life together. The Sun card could even mean that you have the mutual goal of having children, but you have the feeling that this person brings a lot of happiness. There's a lot of laughter in this connection. You're holding back a little bit. I see this beautiful High Priestess card here, and it's almost like you're holding your breath. You know, I want to make sure that I don't get overly anxious. I don't want to show too much of how I'm feeling. I just want to study the situation, pay close attention to what's going on so I can master this. The biggest fear you have is of making the wrong choice. And since we have the Two of Wands and the fork in the road, that makes sense, right? In this reading, it does make, it's very logical to feel that way. So what is your outcome card? The Ten of Swords, releasing an old wound. So we're going to clarify these cards. Let's see what the overall energy of the reading is before we clarify. Okay, what is the overall energy? The Ten of Swords card. Clarifiers tell the story, don't they? Okay, so let's see what we have here. The overall energy is balance, balance, spirituality, and practicality, Aquarius. Let's see what the bottom of the deck is, because look at this. Okay, so we have the Star card. You have been wounded by somebody in the past, somebody that you walked away from. You're still getting over the old wounds. You're just now, you know, in the near future, you're going to, you are finished with the energy. You are spiritually healing from somebody who may have put you in a third party situation. You also have the feeling that this person is going to try to come back and win you back. But it looks like you're already dating somebody else because it's a new person. You want somebody, you want to invest with someone who invests in you. And you are very discerning. You have Libra energy right now. You are attracting beauty and love. You are embodying Venus principles. So let's see what we have for the clarifiers, okay? So what is a choice that you're making right now, Aquarius, in your love life? What is the clarifier for the Two of Wands, the fork in the road? What does it represent for Aquarius at this time? Okay. The fork in the road has to do with the fact that somebody in the past, I'm going to put this right here as a clarifier, somebody in the past was a lightweight in love, and that whatever choice you make, you're going to take your time. You're going to study this, any new choices that you make in love. You're using your, you're following your intuition. You're looking for red flags. Though you're fearless in terms of moving forward, it does show that you're very much attuned to the future. You're rushing in. You have your, you know, you really know how you feel. You have great clarity. And you're going to study this person. You're not going to take anybody at their word, because the last person you trusted stabbed you in the back, and they were a lightweight. They didn't have what it took. So let's see, what is the, why is the Chariot card here? Let's clarify this. Yep, you were involved with somebody who was very ego-driven in the past. This person in the past rushed in, and you did not take your time. You had a tendency to believe what they had to say, and you found yourself in a very unhappy situation. All right, why is the Chariot card here for the future? Ah, the Sun card. You are moving quickly into the future. Your Sun, that is Leo energy and Leo energy. So Aquarius, that's your seventh house of marriage. Look at this. Leo is appearing three times in your reading. That's exceptional. Okay, why is the High Priestess here for you? Temperance. You want a very balanced relationship. You are not going to put up with anything that isn't calm, happy, joyful, reliable, stable. You have just walked away from this energy, and you will never bounce back again into ignoring red flags that really came back to bite you. Okay, this person looks like they could return also, because I see this is also the reconciliation card. So in addition to this beautiful new love relationship, you also have a situation that in which this person comes back. I'm getting the Moon card. So the Moon card tells me that, you know, in terms of what's happening in the future, somebody that you don't trust is going to want a reconciliation. And the answer is no, no, no. You, this person stabbed you in the back once, and you are finished with that energy. So let's look and see. I love it. You're going from Moon energy from the past into this beautiful energy of Sun and happiness and joy. Look at this, the beautiful card of the Taurus Empress. You are attracting this beautiful new love. Look at this. You have this beautiful Queen of Cups energy. The person you are attracting is really tuned in and tapped into their emotions. I do feel that this is very much a love affair with someone who has a lot of fire in their chart, even if it's not Leo energy, but I think they have Leo somewhere in their chart. Look at this. You are about to complete a new cycle. This is beautiful. So it does appear that for many of you, you are in a relationship in which you feel as though, you know, it's time to get married. Your person has left something behind that's difficult. I feel as though they are, yep, they did. Look at this, Eight of Cups energy. They're happy with you. This represents their happiness and their joy. But it does look like both of you left relationships or marriages. Some of you may have actually left for one another. There is a certain amount of secrecy here. So some of you may have left other very uninspiring, troubled relationships to be together. Okay. Why is the Seven of Cups here? So that's illusion, making a wrong choice. You're very fearful of making a wrong choice. You're trying to be very careful. You're at this fork in the road. Beautiful energy. You make the right choice. The Three of Wands is all about your ships arriving in the harbor. Your reality and what you want is here today. You have an offer coming in. So whatever your fears are, look at this Two of Wands. You have made the right choice. And you are discovering that you are in a relationship with somebody who is willing to give you equally, give equally to the relationship. So tell us why the Ten of Swords is here as a closing card. The Hanged Man, you're remembering, you know, you're looking at things from a different perspective and, you know, you're releasing this pain from the past. You are manifesting and you have manifested already a new beginning in love. So for most of you, this is really a tremendous ability. The Devil card does say that, you know, in the past, that the person you released with that devil energy is someone with, you know, with whom you had toxic energy. That's toxicity. That person, I believe that for many of you, this person is still around, because for many of you, you were married to this person and you may have a child with this person. It looks as though they're not really going to go away anytime soon. But let's see about this Sun card. Let's go around again on the Sun card. Yep, good. This person left a relationship to come to you in a relationship. We have marriage and marriage. So it does look as though you may be planning a wedding at this time. It looks as though you have to take into consideration somebody that was toxic in your life. They're still in there mucking around a little bit, which I think is probably an ex of some sort, perhaps you had a child with, because I get the card of the Empress. So though you're happy now and you're attracting love now, I'm getting this energy that you're very much sort of hell-bent also on moving past this devil energy. Your wish comes true. You're able to handle everything. So for many of you, for what I'm seeing here for this reading, is this beautiful closing out of one cycle, beginning of another much happier situation with someone who's on the same page, who wants what you want. They look like they're in the very same position as you. So let's see what your outcome card is, Aquarius. You have chosen a new path here with someone that can actually give you what you want, and you still have to deal with somebody who's toxic at the same time. Well, it's not unusual, right? But look at this, marriage. That's your future. That's the future, near future, sometime after 6 weeks. Distant thunder, clear the air. Look at that. Clearing the air is all about you putting an end to the toxic energy and the influence that somebody had in your life. They cannot manifest you back because you've already manifested something that's happy, something that's healthy, something that's joyful. And it's sort of like that saying at the end of a lot of wedding ceremonies. It's like, you know, what God puts forward, no man can put asunder. Nobody can break this up. There's no way. You're not going to allow someone from the past and the different betrayals that they dished out to you stand in your way. You're moving forward with this great Virgo energy of knowledge, understanding, and really healing. Sending you love from Chicago. Send some back. Please like, subscribe, share, and comment to support the channel. Thanks so much. It was a joy reading for you. Hope to see you soon again. Take care. Bye-bye.